Good afternoon. Thanks for tuning in. You're watching Ask BQ on Bloomberg Quint Live.
On that note, let's get in our experts for today. We have Avinash Gorakshakar of Profitmart Securities who's joining us on the show. Good morning to both of you. Thanks for taking the time out. Avinash, I have to start the show with the question, what do you do at this point in time before we start getting the queries? Because I'm sure a lot will want to know.
My guess is, Agam, I think, the kind of market volatility and the kind of correction we have seen, I think it would make sense for investors to actually play this market carefully. I think there's no need to hurry. The upside would definitely come in, but it would come in once the dust settles down. I think as of now, you know, the markets have got various headwinds in the form of coronavirus. Then yesterday, I think Yes Bank, development happened. I would believe that, these kind of headwinds are definitely going to be negative. And until and unless we see some clarity on both these issues, I think the markets are going to remain volatile. So I think, even those investors who have a high risk appetite could possibly nimble in very slowly, because even quality stocks have been battered down. But I would believe that, yes, this could be a good time for people who want to take a 2 to 3 year kind of exposure. But yes, again, on a very, very selective stock basis and, not at one shot, because typically investors make a mistake of allocating their capital in one shot itself.
Right.
Yep. Historically, Avinash, it could be true. People who buy, around these uncertain times tend to make money, but you need to be brave enough to nibble at these levels. All right, let's get going and start addressing some queries. I'm going to take a query from YouTube. Sudarshan MR writes to us, the first query is on Yes Bank. Does Yes Bank issue is similar to ILNFS issue, and will it affect the NBFC space? In light of that, he's asking, should he sell or hold on to these NBFCs, Avinash, Shriram Transport, L&T Finance, Nippon AMC?
No, I think Nippon AMC has already corrected, and I think one of the reason being is they hold a large amount of Yes Bank perpetual bond debt paper. So, some notification from Nippon has already come in.
They marked it to zero.
Yeah, they marked it to zero. So I would believe that, yes, in the near term, companies like Shriram Transport or maybe Nippon could definitely see a lot of undercurrent. But I think wherever, NBFCs operate in the unsecured finance space, especially, companies like Bajaj Finance, definitely I think the risk quotient now goes up significantly. And I think to that extent, one has to be a little careful. I think one should not nimble into at current levels. And probably if anybody has an exposure, I think fresh exposure is definitely not advised.
Okay. Well, we have a caller now. So let's get in Pawan Nilgan, who calls us from Bengaluru. Pawan, good afternoon. Thanks for tuning in. What's your query?
Yeah, good afternoon. Thanks for the call. Hi, this is Pawan from Bangalore. I am holding the 353 shares of Yes Bank with the average of 89.9, and I wanted to know, should I hold or should I invest more?
Okay, Avinash, I reckon I'll take this one up with you. This is another tough one to call, but what is your advice here?
No, I think my guess is I think many retail investors, Agam, have got stuck up. And I think very surprisingly yesterday, the stock was up by 26%.
Yeah.
So a lot of retail money has got stuck up at various levels. I would believe that, investors should actually exit the stock. Although, one fact remains that today the RBI governor has clearly stated that within a month, I think some resolution would be coming up and they won't allow the bank to collapse. So I think some solution would definitely come in. But for the equity investors, it's going to be a long way ahead. And I don't think, investors could be making money in the stock, at least in the near term. It could be a long road ahead, and I would sincerely believe that on every rise the investor should actually exit.
So Avinash, the viewer has gotten at around 90.
Yeah.
It's currently trading at 15. Would you advise them to wait, or this is the time where you should completely exit, partially exit? If partially exit, how do you go about this one? I know this is a really, really hard question to get call, but yeah. If you could just
I think, Agam, my guess is it's a painful decision to cut out a loss, but I would believe that whatever capital he's making, I think he should take it and exit, because clearly the kind of brokerage target prices which have been given for the bank,
right.
My sense is it's going to be a long way ahead, despite the fact that some resolution also comes in. So it's not going to be an easy way where investors could hope to make some money in the stock in the very near term. At least for the next couple of years, there's going to be a lot of pain for Yes Bank shareholders.
Actually, okay. It makes Avinash makes a pertinent point. Once and for all, I think it makes sense to close the position? All the moves that you're seeing from regulators' side, remember, this is to safeguard the interest of the depositors, not the equity shareholders. And precisely that's the reason why you have seen the stock coming off from those levels of 80, 90, in that case, Pawan's entry level to now where it is currently trading. Very quickly, Avinash, I'm just going to close the loop around Yes Bank, because there are a lot of queries also coming on SBI. Now that they've, you know, confirmed to the exchanges late evening yesterday that they have, board has approved the proposal. Let's see what sort of investment is it, and what Bloomberg reported yesterday, they said it will not be a merger type of a thing. I think that was something positive coming out of that. But still, overall, you know, how do you view this from a shareholder's perspective of State Bank of India, and what's the view on the stock?
No, I think, Navneet, in the short term, the decision to actually whether to invest as an investor or merge it, I think, was not clear yesterday. But now, since they have said that they won't be merging it, I think the markets are definitely not happy with this decision in the near term, because it means a lot of capital gets locked up into some unproductive asset. And I think now, hopefully, if there's some restructuring, some private investor is called and they do manage to get a private investor in the next 6 to 8 months, that would definitely be positive. So I would believe that, you know, one should definitely hold on to the stock, but incremental upside now seems to be limited, considering the fact that this uncertainty is not going to go out in a near-term way. And I would believe that, you know, whatever upside the markets was building on SBI Card's IPO, which got recently completed, I think that is now completely negated. So to that extent, I would believe, you know, investors can just hold on, but don't expect any major upside in the next 6 to 8 months till this overhang actually, goes off.
Okay.
Avinash, HDFC has also corrected for its own reason because of the succession plan. It's a good quality stock. Historically, we've seen the returns. Do you think these lower levels can be used as an opportunity if somebody wants to build a portfolio for long term?
Yeah, I think over the next, say, 2 to 3 years, you know, these sentimental kind of, you know, developments will not impact the long-term trajectory for the stock. Although one fact remains that once Mr. Aditya Puri resigns, I think, you know, it's going to take a long time before the market gets a feel that the new successor is also going to be equally aggressive. But I think if you look at the overall operational metrics, there has been some concerns and disappointments on the asset quality number. But I think still apart, I think, you know, at these levels, if one were to take a two-year view, I would definitely buy into the weakness. And definitely it's one of those well-established frontline banks where risk is, you know, adequately measured. So definitely a good value pick, but from a longer term perspective.
Okay, Avinash, we also have Vijay Lakshmi, who bought Nippon AMC at 480. It's currently below 350, if I'm not mistaken. Of course, we all know that Nippon Life AMC is one of those companies which has had an extremely high exposure to Yes Bank, which is why the stock is down as much as 11%. Vijay Lakshmi wants to know, should I hold or sell because the exposure to Yes Bank? I reckon much of the poison after today will be out, Avinash, but would you ask the viewer to hold on?
Yeah, I think, Agam, frankly, you know, if the investor wants to make a decent amount of money, the investor should hold on. And I think one should also realize that AMC companies definitely would get a temporary hit like Nippon, you know, considering their exposure to Yes Bank. But they have mentioned on record saying that, you know, they have taken a complete exposure. The value of those investments is now zero. So they have taken a hit to that level. I think incrementally, I don't think there are going to be any negative surprises. And now with the change in management, Agam, if you take a 2 to 3 year view, you know, asset management companies would definitely bounce back and make a lot of money. But yes, in the near term, you know, these challenges and headwinds would obviously affect the stock.
Yep, that's the reaction you're seeing because of its exposure. Otherwise, the stock was doing pretty well, trading at life high levels. It had also crossed the mark of 400 just a few days back. Avinash, please keep your answers short so that we can accommodate a lot more queries in the last 2 minutes of the show. Avinash, this one's for you. If somebody's bought Tata Motors and Madison Sumi at higher levels, what would you advise them? They're long-term investors.
I think as of now, I would believe that, you know, on every rise they should exit, because my sense is that over the next, say, 2 to 3 quarters, both these companies are going to be hit immensely, both by the coronavirus and, you know, domestic issues. So I think it's better to exit and probably look at entering these levels, maybe at lower levels.
Okay, Avinash, a question from Anand Kumar. Between DMart and Godrej Consumers with a horizon of 5 years, what would you choose?
I would look at DMart. I think DMart definitely looks to be a very solid stock, and considering the kind of headwinds they've made in the last 2 to 3 quarters, I think they should definitely do well over the next 3-4 years.
Avinash, someone's asking, after what's happened to Yes Bank, are banks like IDFC Bank and Bandhan Bank safe?
Yeah, I think both IDFC First as well as Bandhan Bank, you know, considering the asset quality and the risk management, they have safe. Provided, you know, one is taking a longer term view on both these banks, I think definitely they would definitely be not in the same category like Yes Bank.
Okay, Franklin Manuel wants to invest 1 lakh in Godfrey Phillips. Avinash, a view here?
I would believe that, you know, I think at these levels, I think it would be a slightly, you know, it would be slightly expensive. So I would believe that if at all one were to look at the cigarette space, then I think, you know, probably, I mean, ITC at these levels seem to be quite mouth-watering. I think they have a large retail business or hospitality business. So I think, you know, looking at the risk reward, I think ITC could give in a decent risk reward compared to.